Whoa.
Where's the, we need the camera.
As far as I can see from here, it's long, it's silver, about the right diameter of a 357.
I'll put possible shell casing.
Yeah, right, carefully.
For now.
It's a shell casing.
Okay, how do you change that?
I took anthropology for my first semester and I fell in love with it. And then I saw this forensic anthropology course. I'm like, what could that possibly be?
Once he finishes shooting, then he knocks all the shells out. Or maybe, because those aren't ejecting shells.
You don't know until you do it. And the first time you're like asked to go and help recover a set of human remains, you may not know what that entails, right? And then this class gives you kind of a little insight into that.
Always duplicate your evidence, your data.
Margaret Grover is an adjunct faculty member here. And we were talking, and I was like, oh, I'm gonna bury fake human remains, but it would be kind of neat to have real remains. And then she has a neighbor, he was fishing game. She's like, you know, I might see what they do with the bears. A lot of them came in over the summer because of bears getting into things and becoming nuisance. As they killed these bears, we used their bodies as kind of a way to teach students about the science of recovering human remains.
Seeing the bears in this situation, not quite as majestic, but more interesting.
Bears are great because their hands kind of look like human hands.
You introduce the smells, maggots, all types of cool stuff like that.
The big thing for me with this class was it's catching every piece of information that you might want to have from that site, because once you remove it, it's gone forever, right? And so one day the students just spent learning how to take notes.
Get some key points, you know, maybe like here, here, over there, and then you sketch in.
A heat-seeking camera was great for the fresher of the bears because they were still decomposing, so you could see them glowing in the ground. 3D scanning is after we've excavated the burial, before I remove it, I wanted to get it really good detail of it, because now I can like turn it and I can see where the bones were sitting, exactly how they were sitting. I can measure from the model.
And you can start to piece together what happened. And that's the most important part, getting to those answers, discovering those mysteries.
Studying human skeletal remains is often seen as kind of odd, and people see it as kind of somewhat even gruesome, right? Me, as a bioarchaeologist specifically, I like reconstructing identity, trying to give some idea of who this person was, what their lived experience was like.
It's not as morbid as people think it is. Like, I'm not like doing this because I really love dead things. Like, that's not the reason. There's a real need for it, and it can do a lot of good.
I enjoy helping people, and I enjoy history, and I enjoy the mysteries of what it is to be a human being. So forensics will allow me to help people and answer some of those questions.
For me, the whole point of this class was I would love to train students to get to a level of proficiency that they could at least go out and help identify skeletal remains. We have human remains that come out in areas where we have erosion, we have climate change things happening, we have development happening, right? It's always helpful to have people that can go out and identify them and then help rebury them for a community, right? And students that I'm training, I would love to see more of them go into that direction, because Alaska is a big state, and having people that can go out and help in lots of areas would be ideal, especially in remote areas.
Essentially, anthropology is the study of what it is to be human, and I was actually waiting for this class to see if this was the actual field that I wanted to go into, and after taking it, yes. Forensic anthropology is great.